Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. Welcome to my channel. My today's video is a continuation of part 1 which I already have posted. In that video I have shown the cutting of this tunic top, and now in this video I'll be showing stitching. So let's start. First I will add gathers over here, and then I will attach my yoke over here. For adding gathers or pleats, I will use loose stitch or basting stitch, you can say. You can add gathers while stitching, but if you want that gathers should come equally, you should try this method which I am doing now. I have taken two stitches over here. Okay, it's up to you. If you want to take one stitch, you can, but sometimes while pulling one thread can be broken, so I have taken two stitches over here. So I will start pulling this bobbin thread. From one side I have tied a knot here from both sides, and from this side I will start pulling, and I will keep pulling until I get the width of my yoke from the downside. Here I have taken this part would be my yoke part. I have to attach this as my yoke. Not this fabric, I will choose another fabric, but I will take the width of this part. So I will keep pulling until I get the width of 5 inches over here, and in this way I have add gathers over here by pulling the bobbin thread, and now it's equal to all sides. Okay, and the width is 5 inches according to the width of my yoke. And for attaching yoke I have taken this fabric. I will attach this I have taken this fabric along with the lining. Okay, you can attach a fusion paper if you are using a thin fabric, but if you are using thick fabric there is no need to apply lining. Now first I will attach this on my this part, and this fabric is in width and in length is more than my requirement, so I will cut according to this part by taking the measurement of this. Okay, I will cut according to this, and I will take seam allowance on this part, and then I will stitch with my this top. Now I have cut my yoke part according to the width and length of my requirement. Now before attaching with my top, first I would take I would join this lining part and this part. I would by taking a stitch over here, and you can overlock it by taking a zigzag stitch, and then I will attach with my top. And after attaching with my top I will start making my neckline design. Now after joining the lining part and this fabric, I would start attaching this my yoke with my top. And first before attaching this, first I would set this yoke on my top, and for this I would take the exact measurement from the upper side and from the downside, and then I would pin it up first, and then I would take a stitch. Now I have set my fabric, and I have attached pins over here. Now I will start stitching. This extra fabric I will cut after taking a stitch, and now I will start my stitching from this side. I will put my fabric in this way that my top would be in the wrong side and this yoke part would come on the right side. Okay, and I will start stitching on this line, and I have already marked over here and over here where I have to take a stitch. When you will reach at this point, just take a slanting cut over here, then it will easily turn. After completing one stitch, just take a top stitch over here. This way I have attached my yoke with my top, and I have taken a top stitch over here, and I have cut the extra fabric from the back side, and now I will make a neckline design over here. And if you want to attach band on the this yoke, first you have to attach the back side with this front side, and then you will attach band. As I have to make a round neckline design, so first I will make a neckline design over here, and then I will attach my back side of this top. For making neckline design, I will use pasting sheet. First I would draw on the pasting sheet, and with the help of iron, I would paste my neckline design on a piece of fabric, and then I would stitch with this. After setting my neckline on the wrong side of top, now I will take a stitch very close to this pasting sheet, and then I will turn this to the right side. I also have a dory over here which I will attach while stitching. While I would be taking a stitch over here, first I will take a stitch in this way. Okay, I will set it in this corner, and I will take a stitch over here. In this way I will take a stitch, and when I will turn this to the right side, it will automatically come to this way. Okay. After turning it to the right side, now I will take a stitch very close to this edge, and second stitch I will take over here. After preparing my neckline from the front side, as you can see, now I'll have to make my back side neckline. And for this I have marked over here, length I have taken 2 inches over here, and I have taken this bias strip which I have to attach over here. But first, after cutting it, I will join back side and the front side from the shoulder lines. After joining front and the back side, now I have to attach this bias strip on the right side of the back side. Okay, I have folded this bias strip in this way, and now I would start my stitching from this line. Okay, this way I put my bias strip over here. First I would take a stitch in this way, and then in this way I would join this bias strip. After preparing my backside neckline, now I will take my fitting stitch and then I will attach my sleeves. If you want to make it sleeveless, just attach a bias strip over here and then take a fitting stitch and then fold the hemline. I want to attach sleeves with it, and I already have made my sleeves. These are my sleeves, and these are in circular shape from the front side. If you want to make such sleeves, I already have posted a video related to the bell or circular sleeves. You can check from that link. I would share it in the description box. First I would take a fitting stitch, and then I would attach my sleeves with my top, and after folding the hemline, my top would be ready. And in this way I have completed my this design in the top. I hope that you would have liked this video. If you like it, please thumbs up for me, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.